Good morning, everyone. So let us start our today's discussion on normalization, one of the most important as well as versatile topic from database management system. Already in your today's lab class, you have done with the table creation and how to create and maintain the forms as well as the relationship among the databases and the items. So by keeping the parity with those practical steps, we will try to discuss the normalization so that you will be able to know that what are the significance of this normalization with respect to the databases as well as its application. So let us start today's class. You see, a normalization is basically a process of restructuring the databases or relation. Or you can say in a more simple words that the normalization is a technique used by the database designer in order to remove the insertion, deletion, updation and repetition of data problem from the databases and making the databases or the tables much more robust. Let me tell you, the process normalization will actually generate different subtable. Means if you apply the normalization process on a large table which may contain a different type of anomalies like insertion anomalies, deletion anomalies, updation anomalies, or maybe having repetition of data. So by applying this normalization process on this large table, we will expected to get different subtable. Each subtable will be in normal form. There are different normal form like first, second, third, BCNF, fourth, fifth. Out of that, we will try to restrict our discussion up to 3NF, because as per database designer, up to third normal form is sufficient to work with the databases. And you see from this diagram that a normalization you can think as a filtration approach. So the moment you apply normalization on a database item or table, some anomalies or inconsistency will be removed from that. It will come from unnormalized table to first normal form, then from first normal form it will become to second normal form, and so on. Move on to the next slide. See, there is one example. So this large table we will try to normalize using the normalization technique. For example, this report table consisting of some column like project number, the project name, the employees who are assigned to that particular project in a particular company, the employee names, their designation, what are their hourly rate, what are their hourly rate, what are their hours bill, and the total charges, etc. If you carefully see this particular table, this table contain a huge number of inconsistency. That's why we can't say this table is in normal form. Like every time, for example, when the John, this 101, this John record, when this John news, this particular employee is repeated, his designation that he is a database designer is repeated unnecessarily, as well as his hourly charge, which is fixed, that is $105, is repeated. So there is a repetition of data problem. Another problem is that you see the project name Evergreen is related to the project number 15, and employee number 103 is working on that project. Apparently, it might be seems a wrong message that the other employee, that is 101, 105, 106 and 102, these four employees are not assigned to this project name because this column are null. So inconsistency may be arises. So we will try to normalize this table using our normal form concept. So first we converted this report into a Excel format. This is the Excel format. Then in first normal form, we will try to remove the inconsistency from this particular table by removing the null value with proper value. For example, you see the project number 15, in the first row it is written, but second, third, fourth and fifth, there is no project number. Although apparently we are certain that 15 number project is repeated to all these four rows. So we will do this type of thing. So see, what is database and normal form? It is written that basically there are four type of redundancy or anomalies usually occur in a database, that is insertion, deletion, updation and repetition of data. And being a database designer or a follower, our primary motive is to overcome this updation problem, addition problem, deletion problem from the databases, so that they become much more robust and there will be a least chances of anomalies or repetition of data or unnecessarily occupying the different storage unit. You see, so we are converting our this unnormalized table into first normal form. How we will do that? The first thing for converting a normalized table into first normal form is to reduce the repetition group and overcome the null value problem. So for that, you see the project number in the first row it is written, the project name in the first row it is written, but in second, third, fourth, fifth they are missing. So we will fill them with appropriate value. You see, before and after, this is the before condition, whereas this one is the after condition. You see, we fill up 15 in all this project number and their project name also. So we are trying to remove the null value concept from our tables. So now let us discuss formally the first NF, first normal form. So we can say a table is in first normal form if all the key attributes are defined, means the columns are defined, there is no repetition of group in the table, as well as all attributes are dependent on the primary key attribute. So as far as these three criteria are concerned, now our this table is in first normal form. Next, you see, our table is in first normal form. Next, now let us try to discuss the concept of dependency diagram, which is very much relevant to our discussion, because in databases mainly different columns or attribute used to be dependent on each other, and if we not able to recognize or understood the inner relationship among these different attribute belonging to a particular table, or maybe one attribute of one other table is related to some other attribute of some other table using the primary foreign key concept that we discussed in our last video lecture. So until and unless we define and able to understood this type of dependency, it will be very difficult to normalize our table up to 3NF, because sometime if we not able to understood this dependency among the different data in the different column of our databases, then it may happen that some relationship are going to be discarded or loss in our databases, or some new dependency which is actually not there may be generated, which should not be the case. That's why in your lab we have discussed regarding the relationship among the different table using the primary key, foreign key or the parent-child relationship. Over there, whatever the dependency we are trying to discuss in the form of dependency diagram, this is a dependency diagram. This dependency diagram will try to show the relationship among the different column of a table. For example, you see our employee number and employee name are related. That means the employee name is dependent upon the employee number. Again, the employee name and their designation or the job class are dependent. That means whenever John will be repeat, his designation, for example, he is a database designer, will repeat. The job class and the hourly charges are also repeat. Let me go to the previous slide so that the concept will be more formally clear to you. You see, for example, whenever the database designer John will be repeat in the second row, you see its hourly charge is repeated, 105. So there are some dependency between the job classes as well as the hourly charges. Again, whenever 10, for example, whenever the 103 employee number is repeated, his name is repeated every time. So there are some repetition of data problem due to this dependency diagram. So these dependency are of different flavor. One is called partial dependency, one is called transitive dependency. For example, if you carefully see this table whose schema is written there, we will see for that table we don't have any solid primary key. In that case, we should take a combined key to be treated as a primary key. For our case, for example, we take the project number and the employee number jointly serving as the primary key for this particular table. Now, if this is the case, you see there are some partial dependency among themselves. Now, what exactly a partial dependency is? A partial dependency is a type of dependency that exists between a non-key attribute and a part of primary key attribute, not total. You see, in case of our this table, the project number and the employee number we are selecting as a primary key or joint primary key. But surprisingly, you see the employee name is partly dependent upon the employee number, because whenever employee number 105 is repeated, his name is unnecessarily repeated. So there is a partial dependency among themselves between the employee number and employee name. Similarly, the project name is partially dependent upon the project number. This should not be the case. This is called partial dependency. And what about the transitive dependency? A transitive dependency is another type of dependency which always exists between two non-key attribute of a table. For example, in this table, the non-key attributes are project name or employee name or the job class or the hourly charges or hours, because they are not primary key. Now, if this is the case, the transitive dependency is a type of dependency which exists between two non-key attribute without the knowledge of primary key attribute. For example, for the case of our this discussion, for example, the job class and the hourly rate or the CH charge hour is dependent on each other, because whenever the database designer this particular designation is repeated, their hourly charges of $105, which is fixed, will be unnecessarily repeated. So there is a dependency among these two non-key column of our table. So these two are known as transitive dependency then. So move on to the next. Now our tables are already in first normal form. Now we have to convert this table into second normal form. Why? Because I already mentioned that our motto, being a database designer or follower, to normalize our table up to 3NF for its robust operation. So our tables are already in first normal form because we remove the null value by putting the blank column with the proper data. So now we try to make our table in second normal form. In this connection, let me tell you, we can see a table is in second normal form if and only if it is free from partial dependency. I repeat, we can say a table is in second normal form if and only if it is free from partial dependency. If this is the case, you see, as our primary key is now the project number and the employee number, but still, as I said, that the project name is dependent upon a part of primary key, that is project number. Similarly, the employee name is depend on a part of primary key, that is employee number. So this should not be there, because they are termed as partial dependency. And if this type of partial dependency exists in our database, we cannot say those database or database items, means table, will be in second normal form. So what is the solution? So we have to decompose or break this large table into small table so that this partial dependency can be removed. For example, you see, this entire large table we used to decompose into three children table. The first table contain the project number and the project name, because there is a partial dependency among these two. The second table contain the employee number, employee name, job class, and their hourly charge, because there are partial dependency among employee name, job class, hourly charges with employee number only. And the third table contain the primary key of the first two table with the third independent column, that is hours. You see, if you carefully look the structure of these three which we break up, you see the third table, that is the assigned table, contain the primary key containing in both the table. So over there they will be treated as a foreign key. So we are trying to make a clear relationship among these three children table that were generated with the process of normalization to overcome the partial dependency problem. And now we are able to see that these three tables is in second normal form, because none of the table is suffer from the problem of partial dependency. I hope up to this is clear. So now we will move on to the next level in order to check whether all these three table is in third normal form or not. You know, the criteria for third normal form is a table will be considered in third normal form if and only if it is in second normal form and it is free from transitive dependency, which is a dependency, as I said, which always exists between two non-key attribute of a table. You see, in first table there is no such type of transitive dependency. In third table there is no such type of transitive dependency, means the dependency exists between two non-key attribute without the knowledge of primary key attribute. But if you carefully see the schema for the second table, you will be able to understood that this employee table contains so many column like employee name, their job class, their hourly charges. There are some dependency between them. For example, whenever the job class or database designer is repeated, his hourly charge will be unnecessarily repeated. So there is a dependency between the job class and CH hour, these two columns, which are non-key. This type of dependency are called transitive dependency. And if this is the case, that a table contain this type of transitive dependency, in that case that table will not be treated in 3NF. Although in this three table, the first table project and the third table assign are already in third normal form, because they do not suffer with any transitive dependency, but the second table is in second normal form, but it is not in third normal form because it suffers from transitive dependency problem, which is a type of dependency exist between two non-key attribute of a relation. So we have to further apply the process of decomposition and a normalization in order to break this employee table into more simple table so that this transitive dependency problem can be overcome. You see, as I said, in employee table there is a transitive dependency between the job class and the hourly rate. So what we have to do is that we have to break the employee table as employee as well as the job. This job contains the job class, which is the primary key, and also this hourly charges or the CS charges. Whereas in employee table, the employee number, employee name and the job class will be there. You see, the last two table schema, the common attribute of these two table is serving as the primary key of the job table. So in this manner, there is a relationship which we sustained in our database design. So as we already decomposed these tables into this children table of employee and job, now all this fourth table is in third normal form because none of this table is suffer from transitive dependency or partial dependency. So that is a small discussion. So in our next class, we will try to discuss the other steps. Thank you.